Hi, my name's Sean. I run a research group at UCSF. And for those of you who have written grants before, you'll know that you often have to reformat almost identical data and send slightly different versions of that to different granting agencies. And after doing this manually for like 4 or 5 years, I finally broke down and decided to create a little tool, which is an add-on for Google Docs and Google Spreadsheets to speed up this process. And I'm calling this Grant Merge. And if you've ever done a mail merge, you'll know that this is basically taking spreadsheet data and populating that into a document template. And it's the same idea here. And you know, we wanted to create, for example, other support or current and pending support documents for various agencies. Again, it's the same data, slightly different formats. And then, you know, often different funders will ask for their own variant of this, or the agencies will change their template every once in a while. And it'd just be nice to not have to manually recreate these every time. What we actually want to do is basically put that all of our data in a single source, a spreadsheet, and then use this tool called Grant Merge here to basically take that data and then send it into the appropriate template depending on what we want to do. So I'm going to quickly show you how this works, how to install it, how to use it on some data, and a few little features I included, and then also how to create your own templates. So let's see. All right, we're in Google Chrome here on the website. So it'll be linked in the description. And the first thing we have to do is install. So I'm going to click this blue button on the right. This takes us to the Chrome store. And we click on the free button over here, the plus. And this now opens a spreadsheet. And it's going to pop open a little window. We hit continue. I'm just allowing the permissions to view and manage my documents. And now we see a little pop-up here. We have a new add-on, so we can go into add-ons, but we don't have any data yet, so let's first go back to the website and then go down to number 2 here, example spreadsheet. So when I click on that, I can view this kind of fake grant data, and I'm gonna select this, so you can have to worry about what this means yet, but we're gonna select all this data and then copy it, and then paste this into our new spreadsheet. Okay, so you can see, you know, I can double click these in order to change the widths a little bit. Okay, so we have our data. Now let's go into the add-on, and then we're gonna export it into our templates. So you can see when I switch templates, it's actually gonna show me which columns have that variable, whether it's the funder or the role, total cost. So for example, NIH may not ask for total cost, but maybe the NSF format does. And you'll see that change update when you change templates. But it won't show up the first time it loads, so you have to change it once. That's something I should fix. Okay, so let's just show you quickly how this works, first of all. So I click export, and now it generates links to the GDoc, docx, and PDF, and puts a timestamp there for when it was generated. So we click on GDoc, and here's my document. Okay, so everything's formatted according to my template. And so let's see what we can do with this. So there's some special columns over here. So one is this include column. You don't always want to include everything in every template. You know, some agencies might not ask for pending support or completed support. So all we have to do is change these to no, for example, or, you know, I can change them back to yes, and you'll notice that the entire row will be faded out if it's not going to be included. So there's kind of cool things you can script behind the scenes here to make this really readable. And then let's try an NIH template. I click export, this is going to push my old result down. So you can see there's a more recent timestamp here. This is the new one. It's always on the top. And if I click on the doc here, you can see, again, it's been formatted. Not everything has been included. There's only one pending here. And then if I, you know, if I edit this stuff over here, it'll be updated when I change it or when I re-export it. And then these will just live in your Google Docs drive or folder in a way until you do something with them. And if you want the Word format, you know, same deal, click on the docx here. And then, you know, I can open that or the PDF. It's downloading these. So here's the PDF format. And finally, to create your own template, the thing you'll notice about custom templates, they have to have template in the title. So it basically looks at all of your documents and then shows the options with template there. So I have a couple. I have one where I just left out the costs here. And you can see that cost column goes away. But suppose I want to create an entirely new one. Let me go in here and create a new doc. And I'm going to just call this my template. And we'll say we want Funder. And we want that to be bold. And then maybe a few tabs. And then let's just say, what do we want? Maybe just the grant ID. I don't know why you'd want to do this. But we want the grant ID. And we don't want it bold. We want it underlined. Why not? OK, so now this is our template. You'll notice it doesn't show up here yet because this list only loads when the page loads. So we just have to refresh the page. And we should see the add-on refresh after this. I guess it went away. So we have to go back here and reload it. OK, now here's my template. And you see all these columns got faded out, and just these two options are here. So now I export. And there we are. Now this isn't a great template, so it used tabs instead of tab stops, so the formatting doesn't look that nice. So if I actually wanted to try to fix this to make it a little bit better, I would go back into that template, and then maybe I would create, I don't know, let's create a left tab stop here, and then if we re-export that. Let's re-enable these guys too. So I'm going to say yes and yes. Export again. OK, that looks a little bit nicer. And then you'll notice that these are grouped as current and pending. So that's the last thing that I want to tell you about briefly. There's a special column here, which is type. And type is basically a way to group the grants. And it's really specifically written about around other support. So if I added another type called active, or I could name this whatever I want. You don't necessarily have to use this, but it's going to try to group these together when you export these docs. So, and it does it sort of in alphabetical order. So that's basically all you have to do is define these. And I don't know if I've ever tested this, but what happens if you just don't? You don't have a type. I'm curious about this. Export. Yeah, it just puts them together. So that's kind of an optional thing, but yeah, generally they want the types of grants grouped together, and so you can use that type to kind of group these documents however you like. Okay, so anyway, that's it for the intro/demo. Please contact me with any feedback if you have suggestions or feature requests or just find it useful and want to let me know. I'd love to hear from you, and I hope you find it useful. Have a nice day.